to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Today, we pledge us to a flag that stands for our independence, our unity, and our democratic rights. Our flag was not like this at first. It had to be born and change and grow. The history of the flag is the history of the nation. The first flags in America were foreign flags. Explorers from Europe came to claim this land. The flags they brought were symbols of royalty and ancient tradition. Columbus brought the royal flag of Spain. John Cabot brought the flag of England. Others came, bringing symbols of France, the Netherlands, Sweden. In time, each was driven back. For a while, the colonists felt little need for a flag of their own. But harsh measures imposed by the British Crown roused a spirit of resistance, out of which the first flags of the new
land... ...to the king, and so his sister. This is rebellion.
Who says rebellion? We only want our rights.
They'll hang us all.
Well, if it comes to that, we'll ask for independence. That's why the rattlesnake speaks for us. Let the king heed this.
Rebellion spread. Each colony raised its own flag against the mother country. Massachusetts, the pine tree. Rhode Island, the anchor. New York, the beaver. Winter, 1776. George Washington raised a striped flag over our First Continental Army. But in the corner, it still had the royal crosses used in England's flag. There is a legend that Betsy Ross, a Philadelphia seamstress, made the first true flag using stars and stripes. Three distinguished patriots, headed by General Washington himself, brought her a design using stars with 6 points. She showed them that it was easier to cut a 5-pointed star. The committee accepted her suggestion. And in that quiet room, Betsy Ross made the first American flag. Although there is not proof that this episode actually happened, it has become a cherished legend in the story of our flag. Meanwhile, colonial flags were still being carried to the battlefields. July 4th, 1776. With the signing of the Declaration of Independence, a new nation was born. Now, a national flag was needed. And 1 year later, the wartime Continental Congress made into law our first official flag. June 14th, 1777, resolved that the flag of the United States be 13 stripes, alternate red and white, that the Union be 13 stars, white on a blue field, representing a new constellation. But the Flag Act of 1777 did not say that the stars had to be arranged in a circle. Vermont still fought under this one. Maryland fought under this one. Even while fighting the common enemy, troops from different states argued about how the stars of the new flag should be arranged. But it was one flag. They never forgot that it belonged to all the states. Yorktown, 1781. The revolution was won, and the official Stars and Stripes now stood for 13 independent states. In the years of peace, After the Revolution, the United States built and grew strong. As the nation grew, the flag had to grow with it. When Vermont and Kentucky became states, they clamored for stars and stripes to be added to the flag. So Congress added two stars and two stripes. And for 23 years, our flag had 15 stars and 15 stripes. In 1803, this enlarged flag was hoisted over New Orleans to celebrate the Louisiana Purchase, which doubled the size of the nation overnight. In the War of 1812, England challenged our strength as a nation. In 1814, a British fleet was anchored off Fort McHenry. Francis Scott Key, an American lawyer, boarded the flagship to discuss an exchange of prisoners. After seeing the Admiral, Key and his friend prepared to leave.
I hope your meeting with the Admiral met with success, Mr. Key.
I believe so, sir. That's battle stations.
It is, sir. You've chosen an unfortunate time to come aboard.
So do you permit me to get back to the fort?
Only after we've taken it, Mr. Key.
I protest, sir.
Those are my orders. You may remain on deck, sir, if you will pledge us your honor.
You leave me no choice.
Good. It won't be long. They'll haul down that flag soon.
You can bombard all night. Fort McHenry will never surrender.
We shall see.
It's dawn.
Key, look.
Star-spangled banner, which Key wrote by the light of that fateful dawn, gave the young nation an abiding faith in its flag. As new states joined the Union, Congress realized that adding more stripes would make the flag too large. In 1818, Congress restored the original 13 stripes. Since that time, a star has been added as each state came in. Pioneers marched westward, bringing in more states and more stars. By 1860, two ways of life divided us. We were half slave and half free. A different flag challenged our unity. The flag of the Confederacy.
Lose the faithful mighty Robin Bell of Old Britannica. Lincoln had said, "Not a star will be removed from our flag. The Union cannot be dissolved." The Civil War was the last challenge to our unity. And again, the flag could grow with the nation. In 1959, Hawaii became the 50th state and star. Our history has given this meaning to the flag. It stands for our independence, our unity, and our democratic rights. One flag uniting millions of Americans of every race, color, and creed. A symbol that flies over those places where we must always work for liberty and justice for all. The polls, where we assert our freedom to choose a government representing all the people. The courts, where under the Constitution, every man is equal before the law. The schools, where education for all Americans helps keep alive our democratic heritage. One flag we have fought for, and many have died for. One flag for this whole land of ours.
Out of many separate colonial flags, out of our struggle as a nation to live and grow, has come a symbol of independence, unity, and our democratic rights. To live by these principles is to do honor to the flag. One nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.